Hello, and welcome to the Flame and Fiber Podcast. This is episode 27, and it is March 27th, 2017. And my name is Barbara. You can find me on Instagram and Ravelry as Diva S. And we do have a podcast Ravelry group called the Flame and Fiber Podcast Group. Podcast group under the group tabs on Ravelry. We do have 1 year-long knit along going on in that group where we knit tiny things, little ornaments, anything that's tiny qualifies. So go check out the thread. We have some really lovely, cute, very cute things in that thread. And in my last podcast, I drew prizes from that thread. And we also closed the By the Book Cal. And all the winners have contacted me, and the prizes went out today. And ladies, they should be getting to you on Thursday, according to the lady at the post office, the infamous lady at the post office, if you've watched my earlier podcast. She's a lovely lady, and she said they'll be there Thursday, and I'm sure that she is correct. So anyway, hello. Welcome. If you're a new viewer, thank you so much for checking out the podcast. I hope you enjoy yourself here. And if you're a returning viewer, thank you so much for coming back. I really, really appreciate it. Thank you to the new subscribers. That's so much fun to get new subscribers. And thank you so much for the messages that I've gotten this week in the comments. I really, really appreciate it. So thanks so much. So I'm going to just say it. I am celebrating. I've got kava here. This is, it's Monday night, so I apologize. This podcast isn't going to go up till Tuesday. Typically, my podcasts go up on Monday, but it's a little crazy around here. But I'm drinking my kava to celebrate because, yay, Dennis's sweater is finished. Oh. Yummy kava. It's called Aria. And I will put at least the name of it in the show notes, if not some kind of a link, but probably not a link, probably just the name. But anyway, it's delicious, and it's like $14 a bottle, and yummy, yummy champagne. But I am celebrating. Here is Dennis's sweater. It is finished. Every single end is woven in. The buttons are on it. And it is finished, and I couldn't be happier. Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh. And he's worn it, and I will put a picture of it right here of him wearing the sweater. And I am so happy to have this done. Well, I put a picture in Ravelry and my Ravelry page and, you know, marked it finished and everything. Oh, itchy nose. I always get an itchy nose when I podcast. I started this sweater in March of 2015. So this sweater took me 2 full years to do. Oh my gosh. So this is the Kerouac sweater by Jen Jarvis. And it is in Outlaw Bohemian Sport yarn, which is a Paulworth and I think it's Paulworth and Alpaca and Possum combo. If it's not, I will put it on the screen right here because I don't have a project bag for it. It's finished. I told Dennis I need to show it on my podcast and then you can have it. So I was pretty close to finished last week, and so I had a lot of sewing to do. I was working. I had the pieces blocked last week. But this is a sewn on button band, and it was only partly done because it was interesting the way you do it. So you start on the right side, and so they said to knit 41 inches of button band. And then you're supposed to sew it on, and I have a button, so it's hard to see, but the right side, and I sewed it on so beautifully because it was blocked and everything, and I really did a good job. I'm so happy with it. I'm so happy with it. But then you sew it on all the way around, and then you're getting toward where you're going to want the buttonholes. And so you figure out where you're going to want the buttonholes, and then you're knitting it and then attaching it and knitting it and putting a buttonhole and attaching it and coming down. It was really odd. I put it on Facebook. Is this how they always are? But I'm not quite as happy with how that button bent. But I did. Well, actually, it blocked out pretty nice, so I'm pretty happy with it. I'm glad to have it finished, I have to say. And I have it finished in time. Dennis will be wearing it on our vacation. We were talking about it. He says, well, I'll just need my sweater and my shell and the long sleeves. That'll be enough. I suggested he might need a scarf, but he's like, well, you know, I don't like things around my neck, so he won't do that. But if he doesn't, he'll be cold. It'll be his own fault. But anyway, so I am so tickled to have this finished. And he likes it. And if I got to tell you, though, I blocked the bejesus out of this thing. OMG, because he tried it on. After I got the button band on and I had the buttons just slightly tacked on and I had him try it on and it wasn't closing well and it was really gappy and I felt really bad because he said, oh, I guess I've gained weight. And he got this sad face. I got hair in my... And I felt so bad. I blocked this within an inch of its life and it fits him and it fits him with, and it buttons up without any gaps. And I was so happy that I was able to do that. I was really worried that he was gonna, you know, feel sad, feel chubby every time he put it on. And I didn't want him to feel chubby every time he put it on. So that worked. The arms are a little bit long, but I realized, I talked to about this when I was doing the front and the back after I split for the sleeves. My gauge, well, I started this 2 years ago. My gauge when I picked this sweater back up, because I stopped right where I split for the sleeves, because I got to the sleeves and then I was going to have to think about things. And, you know, it was my first time doing this. And, you know, while you do this, while you do that for the sleeve and the V-neck, and that kind of stopped me. And it stopped me for a year and a half, frankly, almost. So anyway, so I was stopped here right at the end of this green. And then when I picked it back up, you know, in the last 6 months, because I started this again after I started the podcast, my gauge is so different now than it was when I did the body of the sweater. So I don't know if you can tell. Well, maybe you can tell on the sleeves, because the sleeves are really too long for Dennis. Now, you see how those get off? They get off because my gauge in the sleeve, which is the top thing here, is so much looser than my gauge when I was knitting the body. So I was knitting, so by the time you're done with this whole thing, I'm about a stripe off. My gauge is so much looser on the sleeves. I mean, it doesn't matter when he's wearing it, it doesn't show, but the point is the sleeves are a little long because my gauge is so much bigger. When I did the sleeves, if I had knit the sleeves first, that wouldn't be a problem, but I didn't. So anyway, I am so tickled with this sweater and I am so glad that it's done and that it fits him and that he likes it and he thinks he's going to wear it when he's cold, which is hardly ever. The man never gets cold. So, I mean, this is like, in the really, really cold nights, if he builds me a fire, the thermostat is in the room with the fireplace. So if I have a fire in the fireplace, the rest of the house doesn't get heat because the furnace doesn't run because my room is warm. And on the coldest, coldest nights, sometimes Dennis gets chilly in his office because there hasn't been heat for hours. Fluff in my nose. This sweater is for those 5 times in the winter when he's feeling chilly in his office. Or I think occasionally he's going to wear it out and about if he, you know, instead of a light jacket. But he doesn't wear sweaters. The only sweater I've ever seen him wear is he has a cotton pullover that he's worn maybe twice in the 25 years we've been married. So I didn't make this with the idea he was going to wear it a lot, but just sometimes, and because he would wanted it and I wanted to make it for him. So he will get some use of out of it because it fits him and it goes over his belly and he was comfortable in it. And anyway, I am so glad to be finished with the sweater and that he likes it and it fits him. I cannot tell you, but I've been spending a lot of time finishing up this sweater because I did a sewn on button band, which is what the pattern called for, and it worked really well. And I had gotten these two Craftsy courses I told you about, and so I felt confident in my sewing. Finishing this, so I don't know. I'm pretty happy, and I'm really happy with how it turned out. It looks great. It looks beautiful. He likes it, but the other thing is that both of these classes that I took, one was called Fearless Knitting with Lucy Neatby, and the other one I think is like Essential Finishing Techniques for Hand Knits or something like that with Ann Hansen, and both of them showed how to weave in ends. And they both did it exactly the same. And it was much less involved than other videos that I had seen people weaving in where they unwind the plies and they weave one in one way and one in another way. These guys, when they're weaving in an end, all they do is they weave it a little bit at an angle and they're weaving through the plies of the yarns. They're not going under a yarn. They're actually weaving through the yarn itself for not very far. And then they turn around and they weave a little bit more. And then they make a little fan at the end of the yarn. So that the yarn doesn't pull through. And that's how they weave an end. They leave a little fan like that. Can you see my little fan? That's my little fan. And it actually doesn't take very long to do. Now, I'll grant you, most of my weaving in happened where I was seaming. So I didn't go through the actual backside of the knitting. I wove my ends into the seam. But previously when I was weaving in, I was weaving and weaving and weaving and weaving. You know, I mean, like people talked about taking, you know, picking back their woven ends and frogging things. There is no way I could ever have picked back any of my ends because I was weaving them, you know, like, I don't know. They were like the Fort Knox of woven in ends. So I had a lot of ends to weave in here because every one of those stripes had two ends. And because I didn't carry any yarn and the sleeves, and I had a lot of ends to weave in. And, I got tired of weaving in ends. I'm not going to kid you. There were a lot of ends. And it was, you know, but I didn't, if I hadn't watched those videos on how to weave in an end where it only takes you 2 minutes instead of, you know, 15, where you're not making it so secure. So anyway, I highly recommend those classes. I enjoyed them both a lot. I learned a huge amount. And I finished the sweater. And I will confess, the only other thing I worked on all week was my fade. And I was looking for, when I wasn't working on the sweater, I was working for pretty mindless knitting. And I wanted just, you know, to go back and forth. And my fade was doing that for me. So here's my fade. I actually got quite a bit done. Here's my marker from where I was the last time I... Yeah. I have so many beautiful things. You'd think I could come up with something prettier than that. Oh, well. So this is what I've done this week. So I got a lot done. I am now in my fifth color, full bore. Now I'm doing the lace part of the fifth color. And this color is the Woolen Vine Footsie Base in the Stellar Banshee colorway. And I'm really enjoying knitting on this, but it has made me rethink my color choices. My next color was going to be this, because there's like some orangey stuff in here, and there is actually some orange in the Stellar Banshee, but I'm not loving that choice. So what I want to do is I'm going to find a yarn that brings this green, because I love this sort of green and purple here, and then it goes in and it picks up the green here. I was thinking it was picking up the purpley stuff to go with the purple. It's picking up the green, and there's like an acidy green in this color, and that's what I want to follow through with the other two colors after this. So I may go yarn shopping when I get back from my vacation and see what I can find to play into this green, because I'm loving this green. But this is the Find Your Fade Shawl by Andrea Mowry. I'm sure you are all familiar with it. If you're new, you're still familiar with it. But if you're not, it's a beautiful shawl. And I got, you know, I slowed down on it down here, but I'm actually enjoying it. I'm enjoying the knit, and I'm really kind of loving how it's turning out. So that's fun. And that's all I worked on this week. But I finished that sweater, and I am so excited. And I am celebrating. I am celebrating. But we have so much to do. I am so behind. So this is Monday night, and we leave Wednesday morning at the crack of dawn. Dennis's parents are driving us to the airport, which is nice. Well, they're driving themselves home from the airport. We will drive to the airport. But, so we did some, ran some errands today, and tomorrow is like the full bore packing, and I am feeling a little behind, but I have made a list. I have a big, long list. So hopefully I won't forget anything. The only problem is I cannot find my camera. I have a tiny little, point and shoot camera, Nikon or something. I don't even remember what it is. It takes beautiful pictures. I mean, I have taken some amazing, gorgeous pictures with this little camera that I got on eBay. But I only use it when I'm on vacation, because otherwise I'm taking pictures with my phone. But I like to use it on vacation because it's got a strap, it fits over my wrist, and well, in my previous vacations, my phone didn't actually hold very much. Now I have a new phone, which holds a lot. I'm recording this podcast on the phone, so it holds a lot, and it will hold a lot. So maybe it'll be okay. But I'm hoping I can find, I have one more place to kind of look and try to figure out where this camera is. But that's the only thing. I'll be sad if I can't find this camera, because it just does such a beautiful job on vacation. So other than that, I think I'm good. I've been trying on clothes and, you know, summer clothes and figuring out what I'm going to bring. So I'm very excited. So as a recap, if you're new, we're going to Machu Picchu in Peru, and then we're going up to Quito in Ecuador. And then we're spending a couple days on the Amazon River tributaries in Ecuador. The Amazon doesn't actually technically start until it's in Peru. And then we fly to the Galapagos, and we are going to do 7 or 8 days on a small ship in the Galapagos. And if I can figure out how to get a picture of that ship, I'll put it here, because it's like a cool little yacht. We're going to be with a group of, there are 14 of us in our tour group, and that's exactly how many will be on the ship other than our naturalist guides and things, so, and the crew. So it's a small boat, but I'm hoping I can, maybe I'll just take a picture of my computer, or if it's in a booklet or something, I don't know. Try to figure out how to get a picture. If I can, I'll put a picture there. So that'll be fun. So I bought a bathing suit today. Boy, is that a horrible hoping to do. But I had gotten a bathing suit. I had the same bathing suit for 20 years, 25 years. And the elastic, I mean, there is no, there's no, you open it out and it doesn't go back, So the elastic is shot. I actually threw it away. It's in the trash can right next to me. And last year, before we went to our trip to North Carolina, I bought a new bathing suit online. Big mistake, because they just harassed me. That company sent me an email 14 times a day. How many bathing suits do people buy? Not more than one a day. Anyway, and I was never thrilled with it, but I use the same bathing suit for 25 years. I obviously don't wear a bathing suit very often. We don't go swimming in our normal everyday lives. We don't know anybody with a pool. We don't go to the Y, nothing like that. We go to the shore. We go to North Carolina beaches one for a week every September, and that's it. So anyway, but on this trip, we're going to be doing some snorkeling, and they suggest that you have two suits because apparently there may be some days where we're snorkeling twice in two different places, which would be really cool. So anyway, I actually went and bought another bathing suit. I tried it on, so I like the way it fits, although I look terrible in it, but I'm gonna look terrible in any bathing suit, so it doesn't matter. But I like it a lot better than the one I bought last year, so. So now I have two bathing suits, and getting pretty excited. But I will stop boring you talking about my vacation. But that means there won't be another podcast till the last week of April. Excuse me. So last week I talked to you a little bit about my Bryce sweater. I'm not sure how you pronounce it. It's a pataphetic pattern. So I should have looked up and see. I printed it before I was a podcaster, so it's not in color. Bryce by Hannah Fedick. It's very likely that I started this sweater about the same time I started Dennis's. I mean, I wouldn't be surprised. So anyway, I talked to you about it last week because it's my only other whip that I have that you haven't seen me start. So this is a couple years old. And I got pretty far. I've split for the sleeves. I'm going down, and the problem was I didn't have enough yarn. And I had bought another skein of yarn. I had some wacky idea I was going to do this whole stripe thing. But I changed my mind about the stripe thing. So I ordered more yarn. Well, I think even with the stripe thing, I needed more yarn. So I ordered one more skein of yarn. And I don't know if you're going to be able to tell, but I did a swatch. I was worried when, as soon as I saw that yarn next to my yarn, I said, even if I striped alternated skeins, I would just end up with stripes. And it's dark here, and I don't know. I don't think you can really see it, but there is an actual stripe that if I just stayed in this light, it probably wouldn't bother me. You can see it right there. This is it right here. About an inch. No, doesn't show. But I can see it. So I stopped working on it, and then my local yarn shop ended up carrying this. This is Shibui linen. I love Shibui linen. This is one of the first yarns I bought. Shibui linen in the poppy colorway. And I took my sweater with me to the yarn shop to check to see how close the yarns were that they were selling. And I thought they were close. But last week when I was had daylight in here, I thought, oh no. But I think I'm right. They're close enough. And so I think I'm going to be going forward with the Bryce from where I am. I'm going to go slowly. I'm gonna do an inch more or whatever and then see, because my gauge changed a lot with Dennis's sweater. It maybe have changed too much with this sweater. The other thing is, this is being knit on the Denise interchangeables, which I haven't used in a year and a half, and I was wondering, you know, I mean, they're not lovely. But actually, I didn't mind knitting them. Of course, I only knit this much on a swatch, but I think I'm just going to keep knitting them on the same needles and try to finish this sweater. I'm going to try to finish this sweater and see what I think. This is my last work in progress. And it's been on my needles for a year and a half, something like that. I have my fade, which I just showed you. And there is one pair of socks, my cup of tea socks, that I haven't worked on in a while. I'll finish this thought, and then I'll go there. So anyway, I like the sweater. Alternating skeins wouldn't really work well on this sweater anyway, because there is no edging on this sweater. It's just rolled edges. You know, it's a very loose, unstructured sweater. And so there is really no place to weave in ends nicely to, like, if I were trying to, and there's no place to carry yarn up. I suppose if you were switching colors in the middle of the back or something like that, you could have, you know, it would, but it's a pretty loose gauge. So I don't know if you can see it. There is where right here is where I've added a new ball. Can't see it too much on the outside. I can really see it from the inside. So there wouldn't have been any way to really alternate skeins with this anyway, just because there's no band, there's no, you know, there's going to be a collar added. I'm going to pick up and knit this collar. I don't know if you can see that there's a collar. There, this collar is going to just be pick up and knit. But you can see the sleeves have no edging. There's no edging along the front here. So there's no place to hide any kind of structural things like carrying yarn up the side and things like that. So it has to match pretty well. And I'm pretty happy with the yarn I got at my local yarn shop. I think it's going to match well enough. And I have enough to finish the sweater for sure. So I'm going to do that. When I get back, I'm going to work on this sweater. And So this is my last work in progress. And I got to tell you, it's really left me feeling kind of interesting. It's like, no, there's nothing hanging over my head. I don't have, you know, I mean, my cue on Ravelry is a very casual thing. It's not a real cue. It's not, you know, I have no idea what's in there, and I don't necessarily have a plan to make things like that. I mean, it could be, maybe I should just cancel that cue and just really have a real cue and think about, excuse me, what I want to make next. But right now, so in a way, I feel like I can do anything. This sweater has, you know, having these two sweaters over there not being worked on for a year and a half really kind of weighed on me. And I know a lot of people have a lot of people have WIPs, you know, oh, it's been sitting a while, I gotta work on it. I had these two sweaters, and I had a pair of stripy socks that were waiting for an afterthought heel that I started a year ago in January, but I finished those a couple weeks ago. I mailed them today to my daughter-in-law because I won't see her before we leave, and maybe it'll be cold enough for her to wear them. And I made Isabel's. I'll put a picture up here if I can. And those three things are my all my actual WIPs. Now I have the Find Your Fade, which I'm working on, and I have my cup of tea socks, which I started quite a while. Well, they were in for me in February. My first February socks I gave to my mother-in-law for her birthday. Her birthday's on Valentine's Day. So I started a second pair of socks in February, and they have kind of been lingering. But I've come to realize that I don't like to have a very complicated pattern for socks. I can do Hermione's Everyday Socks. I love the Mercury socks. If I can memorize it and just do it, I'm fine with it. But I don't really like socks that you have to think about very much. Apparently, my sock knitting is for my non-thinking knitting. Because I've done lace things, I don't mind lace shawls, but something about socks. Socks are my mindless, I just want to pick it up, I don't want to think about it. I even hesitate when I get to the heels. I'm like, I make a chunk of time so I can get through the heels on both of the socks, and then I'm done, and then I can just do it and not think about it anymore. And it's so funny because these, my cup of tea socks that I'm making, have this My Cup of Tea pattern on them that go up the front. And I made two pair of My Cup of Tea fingerless mitts by Fluffy Fibers in November and December. I made them for my sister and they didn't come out exactly the same, and I loved them and I love the yarn. So I made another pair for her, that two at a time, so I knew they would be exactly the same. So this is the third time I'm making this stitch pattern. But I don't like it on socks. I don't want to think about socks. It's really interesting. So I'll do an all over easy to remember pattern. But I mean, the Before You Go socks by Sharon, that I made. I love the socks. I'm wearing them right now. I really love them. But they took me a long time to make because they each have a little panel of pattern down each side. Each sock on the opposite side, and apparently I want a mindless knit for socks. Give me vanilla. And which makes me wonder why I'm not more in love with like self-striping yarn. I like self-striping yarn, but I'm not like crazy about it like other people. I mean, I think I have two skeins of self-striping yarn back there. Oh, and then I have some Arnie and Carlos and those that sort of end up looking like Fair Isle. But, you know, some people just have scads and scads of self-striping. And I haven't been buying self-striping. It's interesting. I don't know why. Because I want a plain sock. I mean, I want a knitted, I want a easy-to-knit sock. It doesn't have to be plain to look at. I mean, I love the Regia Arnie and Carlos that comes up looking like color work and things. I mean, I think it's terrific. But I want to knit plain, apparently, for my socks. So anyway, so I now have three works in progress in total, period. Nothing else. I have the Bryce sweater by Hannah Fettick. I have my Find Your Fade by Andrea Mowry. And I have my Cup of Tea socks downstairs somewhere. And I don't remember who they're by, but I'll put it down here. And I'm taking my cup of tea socks with me, and I will finish them before I get back. Because I can, knit them on the plane. I can sit there and look at the pattern, and, and that's fine. And it'll be fine. And I am taking at least two other pairs of sock worth of yarn. One issue I have is... when I'm flying from other countries to the United States, if I ask, is it okay for me to knit? The answer is always no, without fail. And so the last time I just didn't ask, and it was no problem. They didn't care. I brought my needles on, I knitted, they didn't care. But every time I have asked, the answer has always been no. So I know for sure when I'm flying to Lima that I can knit. And it's my paperwork specifically says I'm not allowed to knit on the little flights in South America that I'm on. So I probably just won't knit on those planes. I don't think they're very long plane rides. And I will put whatever socks I want to take with me on bamboo needles. And I'll have a lifeline on them. And I am not going to ask. And I'm going to have them on bamboo needles. And if they say, no, you can't bring that knitting on, I'll just rip the needles out and say, here, you can have these needles. And, you know, but I bet they won't care. But if you ask, they say no. This has happened to me more, you know, at least three times. And then I just said, you know what, I'm not going to ask. And that time I didn't ask, I didn't have any trouble. So that's my plan. My plan is on the way home, I'm not asking. I'm not going to ask. If they want to take my bamboo needles, they can take my bamboo needles. And I will suffer knitting on bamboo needles. If I can get them on the plane coming back from Quito to Miami. So anyway, so that's my plan. I'm not going to take anything too big. I don't have tons of room. And it's going to be warm where I am, so I'm not going to want a lot of stuff, like big blanket, you know, stuff on my lap anyway. And I am going to take some vanilla socks and work on my April socks. I'll work on my February socks till April, and then I'll work on my April socks, and it should be fine. So that's my plan. Oh, I'm wearing my letterpress cowl by Sarah Bauer. I love this cowl. And I can't remember. I'm so sorry. I can't remember whose yarn this is. I will put it on the screen. This is Molly Girl. This was left over from a pair of socks I had, this purple. But the other one is a mini skein set. And I've put it down there, and that's who it is. And I love it. It's sparkly, lots of sparkle. You can't even see the sparkle on the screen. So, but I love it. I wore this out to dinner with a friend. She said, "So it's like a necklace." I said, "Yeah, it's like a necklace." So I love this. So anyway, talk. So I have some goodies. First of all, I want to say thank you to Linda. I should have said thank you to Linda last week because she sent me a 6-month Pottiversary gift. Wasn't she sweet? She sent me the Canopy Shawl by Mandarins, Melody of Mandarins podcast. Isn't that beautiful? I love this shawl. So that was so sweet. Thank you so much, Linda. I cannot tell you how much I appreciate it. What a sweet thing for my 6-month Pottiversary. So I am on the lookout. This is a sport weight. It calls for a sport weight. 485 yards of a sport weight. So I have some Adorna Luxe cashmere sport weight that I got as a yarn box when I was a subscriber of their regular box. And I don't have enough for the shawl, but I have, there's somebody who is listed on Ravelry as selling, well, you know, who would like to sell their yarn box. So I've inquired about that, but of course I'm going to be gone in 2 days. So I don't know how this is going to work. But if I can get that, then I think I'm going to make this. Thank you so much, Linda. It's so beautiful. But I'm not doing it until my fade is done. But my fade only has a couple more colors to go. So that's so lovely. But it was so sweet for my Pottiversary. I thought that was the sweetest thing. And the other goodie that I got is I'm in the Grocery Girls had a swap. And my partner was Mary. Hi, Mary. Who is a fiber student in Florida who is headed to France for 10 weeks. I mean, is that wonderful or what? But anyway, my swap box came and I'm so excited. Look at this beautiful yarn. Isn't this gorgeous? This is from Darn Yarn MN, which I'm assuming is Minnesota, but I guess I don't really know. I think I follow Darn Yarn MN on Instagram because I'm very familiar with the name, but I have never seen the yarn before. This is a single, and it is 100 grams, 130 yards. So that's like a worsted weight, right? I think that's like a worsted weight. But it is superwash. All it has marked is superwash. And the base is Medra. I don't know. I have to go on our website, I guess, and figure it out. But what a gorgeous color. And the color is T-O-A-K, which makes me think it's like two of a kind. Instead of O-O-A-K, which is one of a kind. But isn't that a beautiful color? Beautiful. I think it'll be a hat, right? I can make a beautiful hat out of 150 yards, right? Gorgeous, gorgeous, gorgeous. And then she sent me a couple minis from yarns that she dyed. She's a fiber student. So aren't these beautiful colors? These will be, I am going to make tiny socks with these. I think they'll be so beautiful. I don't think they're fingering weight. So I don't know how they would work in my blanket, but I thought they would be gorgeous. Little socks or little mittens, tiny mittens. So I'm going to make those. And then she sent me, oops, my very first, I'm pretty sure this is my very first David's tea. I've never had David's tea before. Mocha orange biscotti. I already opened it. I got it this afternoon. I opened it. I drank tea way too late, but I wanted to taste it. It's a black tea. Its ingredients are black tea, orange peel, coca husk and beans, carob, roasted chicory root, coffee beans, and natural flavorings. Very strange tea. So looking for an after-dinner treat? Try this decadent blend of chocolate, orange, and coffee beans on for size. It's sweet, sultry, and oh so sophisticated. It's tea. So weird. Coffee tea. And then she sent me some beautiful stitch markers that I think she made, and these are so lovely and delicate, and they're like little gem beads. They're so beautiful, aren't they pretty? I got a whole handful of them. And then she sent me this really cute little cat. Can you see the cat? So in a little pouch. Aren't they wonderful? So thank you so much, Mary. Oh, and some soak. Oh, and the soak is Pineapple Grove. Oh my gosh. So anyway, it was a wonderful package and I really appreciate it. Thank you so much, Mary. So this was from the Grocery Girls. Did a set up a swap. And she got her package from me. So I got that package out this week. And all the prizes are gone. And like I said, they should get there on Thursday. Congratulations to the winners. Thank you, everybody who participated in the Buy Your Book Cal. I unlocked the thread if you want to go check it out and comment. Really beautiful things. So, I'm a little scattered. I think that's everything. Oh, but I have notes. I have notes. I have three things. Thank Linda for the pattern, because I forgot last week. I felt like such a jerk. I'm so sorry, Linda. So, I have not been showing you updates on how clean my studio space is getting, because it's not getting clean. In fact, I may have to have another before picture because it might be worse. It's hard to know. But it is on my list of things to do, as I keep saying, and it's getting really boring. But it's funny. Dennis and I, we're so lucky that we get to travel and we're retired. And since I retired, I retired in December 31st, 2013. So this is my third year. Yeah. Just finished 3 years. I'm in my fourth year of being retired. You lose your math skills when you don't use them. You know, what can I say? So this coming summer, we do not have any big trips planned. The summer right after I retired, Dennis retired before me. And right after I retired, that summer, we drove around the country in June. We were gone the entire month of June. And our daughter was in Iowa at that time. And then we went up to the Pacific Northwest, where we have lots of friends because we lived there a couple years and we have lots of friends up there. And then down past Crater Lake and down into California, visited my sister. Anyway, we were gone for the whole month. We were driving. And then the summer after that, we did a trip, 2.5 or 3 week trip in August, where we did a cruise on the upper Amazon in Peru. So this is the second time we're going to the Amazon jungle area. We enjoyed it a lot, and so we're happy to go back with this tour. And so, but we were gone in August, and then this past August we were gone the whole month when we were in Kenya and Tanzania, and we were on safari. And so this year our traveling is such that we're going to be home all summer. And I said to Dennis, you know, I'm really looking forward to being home all summer, because we haven't had been able to do sort of a proper vegetable garden because, you know, we're gone. And I don't expect anybody to feel sorry for me that I can't have a vegetable garden because I'm in Tanzania. I don't expect anybody to feel sorry for me, but I am looking forward to being home this summer. I do have a trip. I'm going to go visit my sister who lives in California for about a week and a half in July is my plan. But Dennis isn't coming with us. So anyway, I am looking forward to spending the summer at home, and maybe we can have a garden and I can have homegrown tomatoes and that'll be fun. But I'm not complaining, and I don't expect anybody, believe me, I know, I don't expect anybody to feel sorry for me. Oh my gosh, I am the luckiest person I know, to tell you the truth. I mean, I understand how lucky I am. Believe me, I understand, and I thank my lucky stars every day, because I'm a very lucky person. And it is all luck, you know, it is all luck. And I recognize that. So anyway, I'm rambling, and think I'm done. Oh, the other thing, I wanted an update on my whole, you know, I had talked about stash and, you know, and that kind of thing, but it really came down to budget. I was tired of going over my budget, and I just wanted to give you an update. I was under my budget this month by $20. And I get my allowance next month and I won't even be home. And most of anything we spend on vacation is not allowance. And if I buy yarn, that will be allowance. But I bought so much the year and a half ago when we were in Lima before. I bought a ton of alpaca, and I still have a ton of alpaca. I have made one big shawl with that alpaca, but I have so much alpaca. So I won't be buying any more alpaca, and I'm not expecting to come across any. I'm not going to be looking for yarn shops. I know, crazy, right? Anyway, I'm expecting not to spend too much of my allowance. So I'm looking forward to having a little bit of breathing space in my allowance department. But that's the update on my budget. So I did good this month, and I'll do even better next month. And so I'm looking forward to that. So I guess I don't really have much more to say, because all I can tell you is that sweater's done, and I'm so happy with the sweater. I cannot tell you. Yay, sweater. And Dennis likes it, and I'm so happy. So I will say goodbye. As I said, I will be missing the next few weeks of podcasting. My next podcast will be at the end of April. And when I come back, I think my plan is to go bi-weekly with the podcast rather than weekly, And, you know, I mean, if it turns out that I don't like it bi-weekly, I'll go back to weekly. But I think it's going to be good for me to change it up a little bit. And so I'm going to do that. So I will see you in a month or so. And I hope you have a wonderful, wonderful month and that you get lots and lots of time to do the crafting that you love and that brings you joy. And I will see you later. I may be posting things on Instagram, me knitting in the wild and things like that. So follow me on Instagram, Diva S. And I'll see you when I get back. Bye.